just my theory. The reason why sometimes okay, let's try this right here and see. We got that depot where you I knew it. This was in there. last video I shared that me and him were the ones who lived like full time at my grandma's, and then the other cousins would come to visit and go back to their home, but we lived with her full time, and he was like my grandma's favorite, and my grandma, she loved me, I guess, in her own way, but he was a favorite. I just remember some of my fondest memories, like my happy memories with them. I liked, I kind of enjoyed making her, you know, shout. I would do things to trigger her. Now it seems so funny, you know. Even back then, it was, you know, something I would do. Had fun growing up. leave it for now, and I'll try the system right here. Some of them are really stubborn. They just won't come out. Let's try this. Okay, let's try this right here. Thank you. it's really like common in all parts of Africa that, for example, if you went somewhere, let's say you went somewhere for 10 minutes, they would be like, oh, she was not here half the day. I sent her to the shop and she came 6 hours later. You know, it's really like a common thing. Like my best friend Kristen used to tell me in university, and Kristen would come and stay over at the hostel with me because she was coming from home going to school, and her grandma would say, Kristen is never here. Kristen just, I see her once a month, which isn't true. She would be home like every weekend. And the grandma would say, well, the whole month I only see her once. So there's that thing that grandmas always exaggerate, even when they're telling a story. So yeah, since I know the story because I was there, and she would exaggerate as she's telling my auntie the bad things maybe I've been doing that week while she was gone, I would challenge, I would say, oh, that's not true. I didn't spend 2 hours on the road when I went to, let's say, take the coffee, because my grandma's farm had coffee. And we would, like, me and my grandma would pick coffee, let's say when I came from school in the evening, and then we would take the coffee, I would take the coffee to the coffee, what do you call it, place where you take coffee, to the manufacturing, I guess, not really manufacturing, it's like a depot, where you take it there, they wait, and then they give you some money. This really happens in the rural areas, not in like the capital city. And my grandma lives in the rural areas, like the village. So yeah, this happens there. And so yeah, I would take the coffee, and then if I took long, for example, if there was a longer line, or if the person to wait isn't there or is gone, because there's that thing where in Africa, if the office is open, let's say the whole day, sometimes the people meant to open the office, they just leave the office like for a few hours, they go wherever they want to go. It's the unprofessionalism for me. And then they can open the office at free will whenever they feel like. I'm trying to pick out this whitehead. I don't know if I'll be able to. I'll leave it for the zoomed. If I took long at the coffee place, the depot, the walk over there itself is like an hour. And then having to wait for the person who weighs the coffee, checks the coffee and gives him money, it's like you wait out there for like 30 minutes, the line is long, more. And if the guy is gone and he closed the office and no one knows when he's coming back, you just have to wait for him to come to officially close the office at the end of the day. And then you can give him the coffee. He can wait and put it in the storage. So anyway, if I took like, let's say 2 hours, stuff where someone was, you know, something awful happened to them. Those are just some of my childhood stories that